Man's name is Casper McLeod. He's a talented guitarist and he's a talented painter. And he found himself playing side by side with some of the biggest rock and roll stars of all time. Thousands of screaming fans showing their approval. His talent and his skill as a musician and as a performer, it won him the role of John Lennon on Broadway and a shot at stardom.
It's another show, another stage, and another crowd ready to rock and roll. For talented guitarist Casper McLeod, sharing the spotlight with some of rock's biggest stars was a dream come true. But as he played out in front of the lights, Casper carried a secret that would almost cost him his life.
I was diagnosed with a heart disease called atrial fibrillation. I was still out, you know, playing with the band and still had, you know, a future planned and all that. And that changed everything drastically. At first, I think I was in denial at some point.
So he'd get ready for a concert, and all of a sudden he had sinusitis and 103 temperature. But I think it really wreaked havoc on his body.
Performing on stage and living on the road meant long hours, empty hotel rooms, and days without sleep.
We'd be up for like 3 days in a row, you know, it'd be like, hey, did you sleep last night? No. How long's it been? Yeah, well, about 3 days now. Okay, we're on in 5 minutes. And somehow this enormous adrenaline thing would happen. We'd go out and do what we had to do.
Still experiencing heart problems, Casper's career began to rise when he auditioned for a Broadway show.
The director kept me for, it was like an hour into auditions, and he kept looking at me and finally went, you know, can you do this? So they hired me straight away to be the John Lennon in the Beatlemania on Broadway. And so I went from nothing to Broadway.
But in spite of his success, Casper's heart was still a ticking time bomb, ready to explode.
Casper had something called atrial fibrillation, and in that the heart beats unevenly and very rapidly, and that can cause a stroke and a heart attack. He also had mitral valve prolapse, where he had some, the blood would have a bit of a backflow in the heart. What this causes in the heart is enlargement of the chambers and an abnormal pooling of the blood, where the patient can make clots that quite frequently cause a stroke.
Deeply concerned about his health, Casper's doctors warned him again about the dangers he faced.
They'd pull me aside and say, well, you know, we don't want him to stroke out. What do you mean stroke out? Well, you know, he could become an invalid for life and paralyzed. And I thought, oh, great.
It would not be unusual for his heart rate to be anywhere from 200 to 300 beats per minute. A normal heart rate is 60 to 100 beats per minute. Not only was the heart rate accelerated, it was actually chaotic and irregular.
Early in his career, Casper had influenced by contemporary Christian artist Phil Kagi, the man who led him to Christ. Casper picked up the phone and asked Phil to pray.
And I just felt this faith come over me to pray for him. I just felt, God, this is a moment right here to pray for Casper. I prayed for him, and there was a transformation that took place. My prayer didn't help him. My prayer didn't heal him. But I think my prayer encouraged his faith to receive what God had already had planned for him.
Then one day, a friend gave him the phone number to a ministry he thought could be of help. So Casper picked up the phone and called the pastor.
I said, my name's Casper McLeod, and I was diagnosed with atrial fibrillation. And that's all I said. And the next thing I heard was, yeah, you're probably a really sensitive person. You're an artist or a musician, right? I'm thinking, how can you possibly know that? I think I dropped the phone, actually.
A few days later, Casper met with Pastor Henry, who shared some important principles from the Word.
And then he told me, I mean, I was 2 Timothy 1:7, you know, for God did not give us a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and sound mind. Okay, you know, I've read that a million times now. And he turns it around and goes, so fear can be a spirit. And that was like, you know, all the light bulbs went on, big fireworks in the background. He started asking me questions about my father.
For years, Casper had carried the blame for his father's death.
My father had gotten murdered a few hours after my son was born. And I remember being a new Christian, I asked the Lord to forgive this man for what he did. But shortly thereafter, I couldn't make the funeral, and I had a relative that said, this is all your fault. So for like 17 years, I thought somehow it was my fault, my father had gotten murdered.
Day after day, Pastor Henry began to minister to Casper and help him understand the root of his heart problems. Casper was unaware that his faith was about to be tested.
So I was playing with the praise band, and all of a sudden my heart started messing up. And I knew something was terribly wrong.
And he began to get a little lightheaded and felt that something wasn't right.
At some point I just laid my guitar down while the praise band was playing and just sort of tried to walk off as quietly as I could.
I was sitting in the audience, and he came and sat down, and he was very, very pale and a little cool and clammy. And I reached over and felt his pulse, and I realized that his heart was racing and it was a little irregular. I knew that there was a chance that he could have a heart attack, or he could actually throw a blood clot and have a stroke. So it was concerning.
And at the end of the service, I felt like I knew I was in trouble, and it's all a bit blurry after that.
After the service, Dr. Allen helped Casper walk forward for prayer.
As the people started to leave, Casper asked the pastor to pray for him, and Casper began to get a little wobbly, and I reached out and was supporting his elbow, and there was another staff member there who incidentally happened to be a nurse as well, and she stabilized Casper on the other side, and he began to get more and more pale, and then he just fell to the floor in a cold faint. The other nurse and myself went immediately to the floor with him, and we each grabbed a wrist and looked across at each other and noted that there was no pulse. This went on for a few seconds, and Pastor Henry came to the floor with us and began to pray over Casper. Pastor Henry said, I know what this is. And he said something to the effect, you're not dealing with Casper anymore, you have to deal with me. And he directed his comments specifically to something that he called the spirit of death. And he stated, you are not going to have this man.
He cast out the spirit of death at that time. And instantly my heart was normal, and I was healed at that moment. Somehow I just knew something dramatically, a miracle had taken place, and I was healed.
And his pulse returned. And when it did, it was quite intense. Actually, I remember commenting that the pulse pushed my fingers up off his wrist. What happened at that point was that he converted from an abnormal rhythm of an atrial fibrillation back to a normal sinus rhythm at that time. And that was approximately 2.5 years ago. And he's not been in an irregular heart rate or rhythm since that time.
Today, Casper McLeod lives the active lifestyle he's dreamt about for years. A living example of God's healing power.
God is so awesome. He didn't just heal Casper of his heart. He healed him completely. He healed his allergies. A man who was always sneezing, coughing, taking shots for allergies, taking inhalers, asthma. He doesn't take anything at all like that. His eyes are bright. His thinking has become so sharp. I think it is a miracle, because I would never have guessed that 2 years later, I have this strong, healthy, nice-looking husband.
It's almost like I can hardly believe how good I feel and the joy of the Lord that's in me. I just absolutely, thrilled every morning I wake up to thank God and spend time with Him.